top 10 private bee schools in India.
Our focus is on cutting edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businesses.
Big Tech, excellence with values.
Good morning. We have with us Rakesh Kumar ji, who is the Executive Director of EPCH, the Export Promotion Council for Handicrafts in India. And we will be speaking with him briefly. Welcome, sir. So what do you think are the major achievements in terms of handicrafts that you have observed being the...
Handicraft in India, historically, it's our cultural heritage. And very rich cultural heritage. For the ages, our caste persons are producing the item which are liked and praised by the people all over the world. In the olden days, Maharaja used to give a kind of a protection for the production of the handicraft item. And in this new and modern world, we are exporting our products to the affluent country, those have money to spend. And particularly additional money to spend to buy these items. What is the biggest area of satisfaction is that in India, this sector provides maximum employment to the people who are from the small and weaker section of the society. And this sector, that is after agriculture, is number two sector where the maximum number of people are employed. And the employment is also kind of a self-generated employment. So this is a very major issue for and a major, big challenge for the country when you need kind of a self-employment. So the investment in this sector is very, very low. Any producer of the handicraft can make the item just by spending 5,000 to 10,000 rupees on their tools and equipment, and then they can produce and they can have their livelihood for the family. The other aspect of this is that in these years, we have been facing some competition from China. This is what people, as a matter of fact, they feel it. But in my opinion, there is no competition as such in handicraft from China. Because for the last 3 years, we are now exporting back to China. And their growth to for the exports of handicraft to China is about to the tune of 30 to 40%. There is a competition with China. Or there is an issue with the China, and that is with respect to the machine made item. Because handicraft which are made by hand primarily, and this is the definition of the handicraft, has no competition with China, but the China produces machine made handicraft. Once they produce the machine made products, then they sell very, very low price product. This low price products is coming to some countries and including India. So my appeal to the people is that they should keep in mind while buying handicraft, whether it's a Chinese or Indian handicraft. If it is Indian handicraft, this will give a livelihood to someone in India. And I do remember a story of my childhood when I was taught that a Japanese lady, when she had gone to buy a pen in particular place in the other country, not in Japan, and take a gift to her daughter in her country. She visited about 10 shops, and every shop she demanded, "Do you have a Japanese pen?" And then she got in one shop a Japanese pen. She bought that and took it along with her. The gentleman who was escorting her, he said, "You are from Japan, why you are wanting to have a Japanese pen? And then you are going back and going to give it to your daughter in that country." The reply of the lady was very simple. She said, "I have now created demand on my product in 10 shops. And also, in the 11th shop when I bought it, the wages and the kind of a sale, the kind of transaction, that will go back to my country." So, I think everyone of us has to at least make a beginning, and we have to buy our product at least in India and abroad both. So, this is my only solution. Thank you.